So let's look into conversion between different number system. Yeah. So first of all, let's look into denary into binary using method one. Yeah. So how do you convert 69 into binary? Yeah. 69 in denary form into binary number. Yeah. So first of all, let's look into this table itself. Yeah. We have 69 on this column, and then we have divided by 2 as one column and remainder as a column. So first of all, you use 69 divided by 2, you get 34 as a result with a remainder of 1. And use 34, you move to the next row, 34 divided by 2, you get 17, as 0 as a remainder, 17 divided by 2, get 8, and then you get 1 as a remainder, 8 divided by 2, you get 4 as the answer, and 0 as a remainder, 4 divided by 2, you get 2, 0 as a remainder, 2 divided by 2, you get 1 as the answer, then 0 as a remainder, and 1 divided by 2, you get 0 as the answer, and 1 as a remainder. So you actually stop when you reach 1 on the last row. And how you can actually form this number is that you actually read from the bottom to the top. So it'll be 100101. So this is the final answer. So it means that 69 actually can be represented by 100101 in terms of binary form. Yeah. So let's look into denary into binary using method 2. So first of all, how do you convert 69 into binary? Yeah. So first of all, we have 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. It means that all this is the power of 2 to the power of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And definitely what we're going to do is that we're just going to use some logic. So first of all, we know that 69 is actually more than 64. It means that 69 is between 1, 2, and 64. So for the bit which actually represent 1, 2, 8, we'll put 0 here and we'll put 1 for 64. It means that 69 actually stands for 0, 1 and XXXXXX. And let's look at the next step. So we will use 69 minus 64, we get 5 here. So what does 5 mean? 5 means that the remaining 5 is actually more than 4. It means that it's actually somewhere here and less than 32 or 16 or 8. So it will be 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, XX. It means that for the numbers that actually represents either 32, 16 or 8, all will be 0. And for the one that represents 4 will be 1 here. And we left it 5 minus 4, which is equal to 1. So it means that the remaining 1 is actually less than 2. It means that so the final answer will be 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, since it's less than 2, means that this will be 0 and this will be 1. Definitely answer can be 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1 as well, depending whether you want to put an extra 0 on the last bit, it doesn't really matter. So this is the method that I actually use when I actually convert denary to binary. I personally actually prefer method 2 compared to method 1. Yeah. So let's look into how can we convert binary into hexadecimal. So first of all, we just need to convert these 0, 1, 0 and a lot of 1 and 0 into hexadecimal. Definitely on the first sight, it will look a bit complicated, but once you know the trick, it's actually quite simple. So this is the trick. So first of all, we'll split into chunk of 4 bits, starting from the most right to left. It means that you must always split from the right and then slowly to the left. So we'll convert the respective value to equivalent denary and then hexadecimal representation. What means that, for example, here we will split into 0, 1, 1, 1 as one chunk, and then 001 as one chunk, and etc. Yeah. So let's look into the example. Yeah. So first of all, this is what we have on the top, and then we're gonna split into chunk of 4 bits. So we have 0111, 001, 1110, and 0101. And let's look into what do they represent in terms of denary. Yeah. So we definitely have a reference here, which is 1248 here. And then let's say I convert this into denary. So 0111 is type of 7 because it's 1 + 2 + 4 is actually equal to 7, and this 1 is 14 and 3 is 5. And the next step I'm going to do is that it's going to convert to hexadecimal. So it's going to be 1, 7 stand for 7, 1 stand for 1, and 14. Since we only can represent single character, it means that 14 actually stands for E, and then 5 actually remains 5. Yeah. So this is in terms of hexadecimal form. Okay, so for denary into hexadecimal, we actually have two methods as well. So let's look at the first method first. So how do you convert 157 into hexadecimal? So first of all, you will convert 157 into binary first using the previous mentioned method, and then we'll turn it into hexadecimal. So it'll be something like this: denary, and then into binary, and finally into hexadecimal. Yeah. So first of all, you know that 157 in terms of binary form actually stands for 1001, 1101, and then we do the same trick again. We split into the chunk of 4 bits, and then we'll make it like that. So it'll be 1001, 1101, which is 2 chunk here, and 913, and actually stands for 90. Yeah. So definitely this is using method 1. Definitely for step 4 is actually optional. So to double check, you can always do 9 × 16 + 13 × 1 = 157. Definitely if you are very confident on your working, you can actually skip this step 4. But normally I will just do a double checking just in case. So let's look into denary into hexadecimal using method 2. So how do you convert 157 into hexadecimal? So as usual, I'm going to build this table 1, 16, 2, 5, 6, 4, 9, 6, so the 16 power of 0, 1, 2, 3. So let's do some logic. So we know that 157 is more than 16, less than 256. It means that 157 is in between 256 and 16, it will be somewhere in between. And definitely the closest number to 157 for multiples of 16 will be 16 times 9. Definitely this is you have to do some trial and error. So the hexadecimal value will be 9x. And let's get the x. So how do you get the x? Definitely you just use 157 minus 144 here and you get 13 here. Therefore, to represent 13 in hexadecimal form, we will actually use d. So the final answer will be just 90. Yeah. So this is actually method 2 and it's also my preferred method. Yeah.